I'd like you to try to determine from a set of data which values would pass the exception test given certain exception specifications. So if you take a look at this example here, we've got three attributes we need to keep in mind as we look at this set of data that extends forward in time here. So these are pi values for a pi tag that has the xdev percent setting at 2. Now that xdev percent is a measure of the deadband that we use for exception testing, and it's a measure that's in percentage of range. Now we also support, in addition to xdev percent, there's also an attribute called xdev in which we would simply measure it as engineering units. But in this case we've specified it as xdev percent. Xdev percent essentially is just a second way of writing that exception deviation, that deadband. So with a span that ends up being 200, with that span of 200, with the xdev percent of 2% of span, that means in raw engineering units, it's actually going to be 2% of 200. That's the kind of a change we're looking for that would pass the exception test. So that would be 4 engineering units. 2% of 200 is 4. Now, in addition, we've got this exception maximum set at 180. That's in seconds. If that much time elapses, we will go ahead and bring in a value whether the exception deviation has been violated or not. Now, there's a point I should make about that that exception max. With the exception max, if the value is at exactly 180 seconds after, in other words, when that 180 seconds has expired, then that would be something that would pass the exception test. So it's going to be a greater than or equal function that we're using here. So given that setup, and given that the first value comes in at 70.3, let's take a look at how we would calculate this. With 70.3, we would add or subtract 4 engineering units to that. That's the 2% of the span of 200. Add or subtract 4 engineering units, and that's the deadband we're looking to go beyond. So 74.3 down to 66.3. I don't see any of these values going outside that deadband. 66. No, that's not less than 66.3. That's not greater than 74.3. And this is not greater or less than. But actually, at this point in time, if you notice, we've got 60, 120, 180 seconds at this point. 180 seconds has expired or has passed, transpired. And so that means that this value right here, because it is greater than or equal to the exception maximum, because this differential between this timestamp and this timestamp right here is 180 seconds or greater, then that means that that will get a free ride. So at this point, we start the whole thing over again, now using this as the linchpin. So we're looking for anything that is either 180 seconds out from this timestamp or something that goes above and below the 70.1 plus or minus 4 engineering units. And in this case, what would that be? That's going to be 74.1 down to 66.1. Well, that is not greater than 74.1 or less than 66.1. However, this is less than 66.1. That's the 70 minus 4 engineering units. So this value here will also go into the snapshot. So now we've got this value here, and this value here would be the next snapshot event. And then we start the whole thing over again, now using 66. So with 66, we're looking for something that goes either to 70 or down to 62. That doesn't make it, but this does. This actually passes on two counts, I suppose. First of all, because it's less than 62. And then also, it's been exactly 180 seconds. So in this case, we bring this value in. So in summary, what we see is this value right here, this value right here, and then this value right here are the values that actually pass the exception test.